all of this information is being generated in Blackboard for every course, not just the ones that we're tracking. So I'm going to show you how you can pull these reports from within your courses. So these reports include overall course activity as well as detailed individual student activity. So all this information, everything you need to know to generate these reports, is available within the course reports area of Blackboard. And that within the instructor view of Blackboard is in the evaluation dropdown on the control panel. So if you click on course reports, you'll see that there are several reports that are available. For the purposes of learning analytics, we've determined that the overall summary of user activity report is the most applicable, at least at the moment. So if you run that overall summary of user activity, and you can specify the date range, you will get a lot of information based on hits. So that's page views or page loads in each section. So using this example, which is from early in the semester, this is from 1 week early in the semester, you can see that the majority of students viewed content items and announcements, and very few hits occurred in grades, which makes sense because it's the beginning of the semester. But you can use this to get a snapshot, whether it's one day or a week or all semester, of the areas that are receiving the most hits within your course collectively for all the students. You can also see distributed throughout the week. So in this case, day one is Sunday. So you can see the majority of students, 38%, are hitting the site or different areas of the site on Sunday. And then the second most is Monday with 20%. And then it drops off on Tuesday and kind of tapers off throughout the week. And this class meets on Monday, so you can see the majority of students are logging in right before the class. And perhaps you determine that you want a more even distribution, so perhaps requiring them to log in and do activities later in the week might be somehow you could change this distribution. You can also see distribution throughout the day on average. In this case, students are logging in and having hits in the afternoon around 2 and 3 p.m. and then again in the evening. So just on average throughout each day. And so those are pieces of data from all over, from all the students in the course, but you can also zoom in on individual student activity. And you can use triggers to determine interventions within your class. So in this case, you can see from August 24th through 30th, you can see the daily number of hits per student over here, which are blurred out for this example. And then you can also see the total for the week. So you may be able to determine an intervention based on this data. You can see that some students are logging in upwards of 60, 70, 80 times and creating those number of hits throughout the week, and others are less than 20. Therefore, it may be a potential trigger for a student intervention to have less than 20 hits per week. So that's a general overview of how to generate these reports and how you might use those in your classes. On the table, there's a printout of a PDF that's actually going to be made available online, and the link will be on the CTL website.
It's on the ITS. If you go to its.sdsu.edu, it's right there on the front page.
And it will be on the CTL website associated with this lunch.
So this is a walking you through step by step of how to generate these reports, and I'm also going to be doing that after this presentation. If you want to stick around and have time, I'm going to be going through and showing how to generate these reports. Okay.